Hello. You are on the channel Kurt of CG Computer Graphics. This is the continuation of the Cinema 4D Marathon. In this we will talk about rendering settings. But before we start, subscribe to the channel if you are not subscribed, and now let's get started. In the previous video, we created the material for the objects. I changed the color of the materials a bit and added more ingredients. Let's move on to the render settings. Let's start with physical rendering. With it, the picture looks much better than with the standard render. Output in this tab, select the render resolution. Next is the frame rate. Typically, animation is set to 24 frames. But check your project settings and see how many frames are in the project itself. They must be the same. The frame range here is where we choose what to render. The entire timeline or a specific frame. The Save tab here we choose in what format the render will be. I usually use PNG. A place to save the render. If you check the alpha channel, then the render will be with a transparent background. Let's move on to the main tab of the physical render. Here we select a render mode, usually it is adaptive. But, if this is a draft, and you need to quickly check how the picture looks, you can enable progressive rendering. Next is the quality of the render. For the final render, I choose medium. Further effects. As you can see, two effects have already been added, global illumination and ambient shading. After setting up the render, you need to run it. To do this, click Render to Picture. I hope the video was helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. In the next video we will talk about sculpting in Cinema 4D R26. Thank you all and goodbye.